मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वानोमीटर। मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वानोमीटर इज यूज टू मेजर द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इन सर्किट एंड वोल्टेज ऑफ द बैटरी। इट वर्क्स ऑन द सिंपल प्रिंसिपल और कंसेप्ट दैट वी हैव स्टडीड इन द अर्लियर टॉपिक, दैट इज द टॉर्क एक्टिंग ऑन द करंट कैरिंग लूप इन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। विल सी द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल इज वेन द कॉइल कैरिंग द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज फ्रीली सस्पेंडेड इन यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, टॉर्क एक्ट्स ऑन द कॉइल एंड दिस टॉर्क रोटेट्स द कॉइल। Therefore, in terms of the torque acting on the coil or deflection in the coil, we can measure the current passing through the moving coil galvanometer. Now, you see the construction of the moving coil galvanometer. This is the cross-sectional diagram of the moving coil galvanometer. Moving coil galvanometer consists of the coil having the several turns of the thin copper wire wounded on the non-magnetic frame of the aluminium, and this coil is suspended in uniform magnetic field so that it can freely rotate about the axis of suspension. There is the soft iron cylindrical core which makes the magnetic field radial and very strong. The coil is suspended by the phosphor bronze thin wire or fiber, that is the upper suspension, and the small plane mirror is attached to it. This mirror helps in lamp and scale arrangement. Lower end of the coil is attached to the phosphor bronze helical spring, that is the lower suspension, which helps to lead the current in and out of the coil. The elastic behavior of this helical spring attached to the lower end of the coil helps bring back the coil to its original position when the current is cut off. As the coil deflects due to the torque, the pointer attached to it deflects on the uniform scale, and thus we can measure the electric current or voltage. Now we'll see the theory. As the current passes through the coil, torque acts on it, and this torque rotates the coil about the axis of suspension, and therefore this torque is called as the magnetic torque or deflecting torque. We can write here the magnetic torque is given by Ni A multiplied by B. This equation we have derived in the earlier concept, where N is number of turns of the coil, I is the current in coil, A is area of coil, and B is the magnetic field induction. Here sin theta is equal to 1, since this iron cylindrical core makes the magnetic field strong and radial, and therefore the plane of the coil always remains parallel to the magnetic field, and therefore for all the positions of the coil the magnetic torque acting on the coil remains the equal and same, which is given by Nia multiplied by B. Magnetic torque deflects the coil, then pointer attached to the coil, this pointer attached to the coil also deflects on the uniform scale. Now, due to this deflection in the coil, the wire also gets twisted, and this twist in the wire and the deflection in the coil produces the restoring torque in the spring, and this is called as the counter torque or restoring torque. As the current is larger, deflection in the coil also will be larger, and therefore restoring torque will also be larger, and therefore you can say that the restoring torque, or here we can say that it is counter torque, is given by Tc is equal to के मल्टीप्लाइड बाय फाइ. दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर टू. हियर के इज द टॉर्शनल कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ द स्प्रिंग एंड फाइ इज द डिफ्लेक्शन एट द इक्विलिब्रियम पोजिशन. दिस काउंटर टॉर्क बैलेंस इज द मैग्नेटिक टॉर्क सो दैट स्टेडी करंट पासिंग थ्रू द क्वाइल मेक्स द स्टेडी डिफ्लेक्शन फाइ. And therefore, you can say that at equilibrium, the counter torque balances the magnetic torque, and therefore, you can write counter torque is given by K phi is equal to magnetic torque, that is NIBA. Therefore, here we can write the angle of deflection, that is phi, is equal to NBA divided by K multiplied by I. But the terms in the bracket, that is N, number of turns, B is the magnetic field induction, A is the area of the coil, and K is the torsional constant of the spring. All these terms are constant, and therefore here we can write the deflection phi is directly proportional to current, and by using this relation we can measure the electric current passing through the coil.